afternoon, good morning, right? Good afternoon, good morning. My name is Senator Semper Felden.
I read whatever you write.
It's a good thing you didn't say my name is Senator somebody else. My name is Senator Semper Felden. I'd like to welcome all of you to the Senate Standing Subcommittee on New York City Education. Today, we have four bills to be considered by the committee. Our first bill is Senate Bill 2464 by my esteemed colleague, Senator Lanza. Council will read.
Senate Bill 2464 by Senator Lanza, an act to amend the education law in relation to requiring the reporting of the results of English language arts and mathematics assessments to the person in parental relation to each elementary school pupil who is so addressed.
Assessed.
Thank you.
Sometimes I get it.
Sometimes.
I'll entertain a motion.
Move the bill.
Second.
Yep. Bill is reported to education.
Our next bill is Senate Bill 7016. I just wanted to thank and welcome my colleagues, Senator Lanza and Senator Perkins, who are with us this morning. Is Senate Bill 7016, said by Senator Stavisky. Council will read.
Senate Bill 7016 by Senator Stavisky, an act to amend the education law in relation to the request by parents for translated documents for students with disabilities.
I'll entertain a motion.
Move the bill.
Second.
Second.
Bill is reported to education.
There are two last bills. Can you tell them to shut off the camera? Our next bill is Senate Bill 7376 by Senator Felder. Council will read.
Senate Bill 7376 by Senator Felder, an act to direct chancellors of city school districts in cities having a population of 1 million or more to examine and assess the feasibility of expanding the number and types of career and technical education schools and programs within such city school districts.
Yeah. Question and comment. I think this is a good bill. And I just want to also thank Ms. Campbell.
Yes.
Giving me some insight as well as your staff. And in fact, she also shared with me a hearing that's going to be taking place on Friday. About these type of schools in New York City. So I'm very interested in that. And so clearly I support the bill and move it.
Yeah, I appreciate the news as well. I'm hoping that maybe next time we can find out about it earlier so that we have others who might be able to attend or move their schedule around. But we're very happy that there's a hearing taking place. We have a motion to move the bill.
Second.
The bill is reported to education.
Yeah, I don't usually comment on the bills, but this one is very, very important. The one that we just talked about.
Can you explain?
Yeah.
Is this your bill? Is that the one we're talking about?
The last one.
Never mind. We need the tapes on this hearing. this is my bill, and it's not the last bill today, but I just wanted to make a comment that this bill is very dear to me personally, because I feel that when I was in high school, if this had existed and been available to many, many children,
you wouldn't be here today.
We gotta get this bill straight to the floor.
I guess my strategy worked perfectly. So the purpose of the bill really is to make sure that all kids have an ability to succeed and feel good about themselves, have self-esteem, and be happy, really, like the happy song. Right? Be happy, because at the end of the day, if children are happy and feel good about themselves, they will succeed at everything and anything they want to do. And it's clear that not everyone is cut out to sit in a classroom setting for hours and hours a day. And not only isn't it helpful, it causes a lot of grief In my case, when I was in yeshiva, sitting there many hours, I was not a good student, and, are you shocked?
I am.
Yeah. And it really caused a lot. I'll tell you at another time, I'll tell you all the issues. But at the end of the day, the fact is that there are thousands and thousands of students that would really excel.
Sure.
Excel, and we need, there are a lot of careers that don't exist anymore. We need excellent electricians, we need great plumbers, we need contractors, and by having schools that offer vocational alternatives in vocational education, this is the key to, at least one of the keys to making sure that all children, I would say particularly in neighborhoods where there are poor families and in ethnic neighborhoods, including my own district, where a lot of the kids will wind up not going to college and could wind up having the benefit of an alternative education. So I appreciate your support on this bill.
Thank you.
Our last bill is Senate Bill 7407 by Senator Sanders. Council will read.
Senate Bill 7407 by Senator Sanders, an act to amend the education law in relation to requiring community district education councils to establish safety hazard advisory review committees.
Can I just ask a little question on this? I just wonder, how would those committees function? I mean, I'm supporting, I just don't quite understand exactly how they might.
I think that, as I read the bill, it looks like the committee, as a community council, would kind of designate a committee on safety, and subcommittee on safety. And it looks to me, as I'm reading the bill, that if a parent makes an application for a variance, then the committee would actually go out and almost like walk the site to see what the situation's like, you know, why there's a need for the safety, and they make recommendations.
So the parent would ask for a variance of what?
I suppose like there may be some safety issue the parent sees for the child, mm-hmm. and then they say we want to deviate from whatever the norm is.
Like for instance, to get a bus.
Or a traffic light or some other kind.
I'll entertain a motion.
The bill.
Second.
Bill's report to education.
This concludes today's meeting of the Senate Standing Subcommittee on New York City Education. Thank you.
Thank you very much.